With an all-time record of 152 wins and 52 losses, Fulmer guided the Volunteers from 1992 to 2008 and claimed the very first BCS National Championship game in 1998 while receiving National Coach of the Year honors. Tennessee coach Phillip Fulmer to enter the College Football Hall of Fame.
Obviously, just from the standpoint of joining such an elite group of coaches and players in an organization like the National Football Foundation Hall of Fame, you know, I'm honored. Something like that doesn't happen with an awful lot of commitment by a lot of people, and I have to start with my wife and my children and the price that they paid for me to do a profession that I had a passion for. And it was never a job from our standpoint. It was always a lifestyle that we certainly enjoyed, and I'm grateful to them for allowing me to do that. Staff-wise, I mean, we had an unbelievable group of people at my time at UT that were great friends and great workers that were extremely loyal to me and to the program, and you certainly have to appreciate what they did. Countless players that chose to come to Tennessee and trusted us to do well for them, and we were able to do that in most cases. It would be almost an injustice to start naming names because there were so many of them and you would leave people out, but I appreciate their contributions, and they had a chance to be a part of the best era in Tennessee's modern football history, and they have to have left proud of that. I've had the occasion this morning to talk to Coach Dickey and to Joe Johnson and to Bill Battle, the guys that were extremely influential in me getting into coaching and then becoming a head coach. I appreciate Coach Dickey and Joe Johnson particularly for giving me the opportunity, and went to work every day to prove that they had made a good decision. So those guys were special. You can go on and on because it took a lot of people, a village, as they say, to do what we did. But I'm proud of our record, obviously, and that we wouldn't be having this meeting if we didn't have a good record. But I'm also very proud of how we did it. We created very much a family atmosphere that was a positive, growing place for young men, and we also, at the same time, we stayed away from any kind of violations and NCAA things at that. So there's a lot to celebrate when we get to New York, and we will certainly do that.